This is the Trons, a self-playing robot band made entirely from bits of junk. Move over, Daft Punk. This is real robot rock.
The Trons are totally lo-fi. This guy has taken a whole bunch of junk and put it together to create something amazing.
Their manager, Greg, is a true homemade hero, having built the Trons over the last 15 years. So, Greg, what are the band like to work with?
There's a lot of setting up, which is probably the hardest thing, and I have to do it all, so there's a lot of gear lugging. You know, the robots aren't really much help with that sort of stuff. But once everything's set up and they can play 3-4 hours and not get upset about it, quite interesting at gigs, the way, you know, people aren't quite sure how to respond to machines. But I usually find that they sort of, you know, they clap, they dance, you know, I've even had stage divers.
Since appearing on the internet 4 years ago, the Trons have become an international sensation. Sold out gigs, critical acclaim, and even groupies. But what or who is telling the Trons when to pluck a string or hit a drum?
In the computer that's running the Trons, there's a sequencer. And the sequencer keeps track of which notes need to be played and when they should be played. And it's the sequencer which is keeping all the Trons on time and playing the notes when they're supposed to be played.
Full credit goes to Greg, and he quite rightly calls himself the manager. Although I suspect he takes a bigger cut than most managers. You know, most management take about 10%. I suspect Greg's on more like 100.
You start off, you've got a robot band, it's quite cool, they do a bit of tours, they play some gigs, and then I think this is just the first step on the road towards the robots dominating us and taking over the world in the future.